Hello children, today we are going to discuss excretion in animals. Children, what is excretion? The process of removal of waste product produced in the cell of the living organism is called excretion. As I told you, so many vital activities are taking place in the body, and during those reactions, large amount of waste is produced. Okay, so we are going to talk excretion in humans. The human body has specialized organs for the removal of various waste product formed in the body. These organs, first is large intestine, children, like in digestive system. When the waste is produced, okay, the undigested food is removed from the large intestine and expelled out of the body through the anus in the form of feces. Second, lungs. Children, lungs. You have learned about lungs in respiratory system. Carbon dioxide is produced as a waste product in our body cells during the process of respiration. Okay, when food is broken down to release energy, that time carbon dioxide is produced. This carbon dioxide is removed by the lung during exhalation process. Third is skin. Our skin helps in eliminating excess of water, urea, some salts and other metabolic waste. What thing I told you? Water, urea, some salts and other metabolic waste in the form of sweat. What is sweat, children? Jisko Hindi mein kehte hain pasina. Sweat is a liquid waste secreted from the sweat gland below the skin. So, sweat glands are present below the skin and they help in removing water, urea, some salts and other some minerals also, okay, mineral salts. Now, it is very important. Sweating is very important. Two ways it is important. First, it helps to remove excess water, some salts, urea as liquid waste from the body. And second, it maintains our body temperature. It helps keep our body cool during summers. Okay, in summers we sweat a lot, so it keeps our body cool. Now, number fourth, kidney. Okay, we are going to discuss about kidney in detail. Okay, kidneys are the main excretory organs you are seeing in the picture in our body. They help in eliminating urea, water, excess of water, salts, waste salts, and excess of water. I told you already, these three things are removed from our body. Excretory system in human consists of the following organs. First is kidney. Second is ureters. There is one pair of kidney, one pair of ureters. Okay. Urinary bladder where it gets collected. And fourth is urethra from where this is expelled out. Okay, children. So, I have drawn this here. First, we are going to discuss about kidney. A pair of kidneys are present in humans. These kidneys are situated at the level of the waist of either side of the vertebral column. Okay, kidneys are brick red in color. What is the color? Brick red, and they are of bean shaped. Bean is clear? Rajma bean, so it is bean shaped. Each kidney contains large number of coil tubes called nephrons. Children, nephrons are filtering units. They are like this. Okay? And tube is attached in this long tube. You are going to study about this nephron in detail in higher classes. So, nephrons are filtering unit, and in this capillaries are there. Now you know arteries and veins. Artery, vein, and in between what is there? Capillaries. Now the concept is clear. So there are millions of nephrons are there in the kidney. Okay, nephrons, they act as filter. When the blood enters, reaches the two kidneys, it contains both useful and harmful substance. This blood is coming. Okay. It contains both useful and harmful substances. The useful substances are absorbed back into the blood. Because in capillaries, exchange is taking place. So, useful substance, they are absorbed back in the blood and the waste, and harmful substance, okay, the useful, I told you the useful substances are absorbed back into the blood, and the waste product dissolved in water are removed from the kidneys as yellowish liquid called urine. Water and the uric acid filter and it goes to the tube. And ultimately from this tube, it goes to the ureter. Okay, it goes to the ureter. I told you about the nephron. The nephron acts as a filter and removes harmful substances. Clear, children? Millions of nephrons are there. They act as filter and they remove harmful substances in the form of urine. The urine formed in the kidneys goes into the urinary bladder through the tube called ureters. These yellow tubes you are seeing called ureters. Urine is stored in urinary bladder and is passed out from the body at regular interval through the urinary, through this opening we call that urethra. Okay. Children, an adult human being normally passes about 1 to 1.8 liter of urine in 24 hours. The urine consists of 95% water, 2.5% urea and 2.5% other waste products like uric acid and ammonia. Okay, children. Now, sometime what happens, this kidney stops working and we say kidney failure is taking place. Okay. Kidney failure is taking place. Then what happens? The waste product which it filters, that start accumulating in the blood. And the person may die due to that poisonous substances in a week or so. Okay, the usual treatment for kidney failure is either dialysis or kidney transplant. Two things we can, first is dialysis. And second is kidney transplant. First, we are going to discuss about dialysis. The process of cleaning the blood of a person by separating the toxic waste product using a dialysis machine is called dialysis. Here we use machine. Okay. To perform dialysis, the blood from the artery. Children, you can see this in YouTube also. With YouTube videos. That first, what happened to perform dialysis, the blood from an artery of the patient arm is passed through the dialysis machine. From artery, it goes to the dialysis machine. There, this purification takes place. That thing that took place in nephron, same thing take place in what? Dialysis machine. Okay. and the waste product are removed from the blood, the clean blood is pumped back into the veins. This clean blood come back to the vein of the patient's arm. The dialysis continues till all the blood in the body has been cleaned. This treatment has to be done regularly. Now next is, if kidney failure is there, the next thing we can do, that is kidney transplant. Kidney transplant. Okay. The damaged kidney can also be replaced by another person's healthy kidney by a surgical procedure. We have discussed excretion in humans, and now we are going to discuss excretion in plants. The main product excreted by plants are carbon dioxide and oxygen. Carbon dioxide and oxygen. Carbon dioxide is formed as a result of respiration process, and oxygen is formed as a result of photosynthesis. So both the gases need to be excreted from the plants. Okay, so daytime we say plant gave oxygen, excess of oxygen it is having, and during the night, because it cannot utilize that carbon dioxide, so it excretes carbon dioxide during the night in excess. Acha, second is, it also excretion, it also excrete what? Excess of water in the transpiration. I told you transpiration process, because root keeps on absorbing water, and excess of water it removes through stomata. Third, excessive salt. Excessive salts. If there is a high level of salt present in water or in the soil, like in marine water and all, too much of salt is there, or sometime we give manure and all, too much of salt is there, they usually get deposit in the plant as crystals. Okay, they move out in the form of crystals. Gums, resins and latex, children, these are the excretory products of the plant, but they are useful for us. Okay. Many old plants get rid of their toxic waste in the form of gum, resins and latex. We use these secretion to manufacture paints, varnishes, rubber and adhesives. Okay, children. Bye-bye.